us. Also, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to the distinguished scholars, colleagues, delegates, presenters, and moderators at the different location on the globe of the world. First of all, I will introduce my sincere thanks to the conference management to provide a facility to deliver my talk at this important conference. Let me inform you that this is a multidisciplinary conference, and I am sure you agree with me that every scientist is not familiar with every subject of the science. Therefore, at the beginning of my talk, I will introduce the basic terms and definitions related to the Chapman-Mehr alloys, reversibility, and other aspects of Chapman-Mehr effect. After that, I will introduce the experimental studies performed on two copper-based Chapman-Mehr alloys. Also, I wish you great success at the session, and we will be together whole day at the session. As you can see, the title of my presentation is Scientific and Engineering Aspects of Shape Reversibility in Chapman-Mehr Alloys. Metals and alloys have different phases at the different condition in the phase diagram as composition temperature or composition pressure dependent. A series of alloy system exhibit a peculiar property called Chapman-Mehr effect in the beta phase region. These alloys are very sensitive to the external condition, and crystal structures turn into the other crystal structures by means of crystallographic transformations. That this vibration, phonons, internal friction, and interatomic potential play an important role in the processing of transformation and Chapman-Mehr effect. This behavior is governed by thermal and stress-induced microelectric transformations. Chapman-Mehr effect is initiated on cooling and deformation processes and performed thermally on heating and cooling in the bulk level, and this behavior can be called thermoelasticity. These materials cycle between deformed and original shapes on cooling and heating. These alloys exhibit another property, which is superelasticity, which is performed by mechanically stressing and releasing in the elasticity limit at a constant temperature at the parent phase region. Chapman-Mehr effect and superelasticity is result of the crystallographic transformations, thermal and stress-induced microelectric transformations, and evaluated by the structural change in atomic scale. Chapman-Mehr effect is performed thermally in a temperature interval, depending on the forward austenite martensite and the reverse martensite austenite transformations on cooling and heating. Superelasticity is performed in the parent phase region just above the austenite finish temperature. For the superelasticity, materials are stressed in the elasticity limit in the parent phase region, and shape recovery is performed instantly and simultaneously upon releasing the applied stress by representing elastic material behaviors. This is the processing of shape memory and mechanical memory in the bulk level. As I mentioned, shape memory effect is performed on cooling and deformation. And in the shape memory effect, material is deformed in the low temperature condition This is plastic deformation and material keeps the deformed shape after releasing, and on heating, material recover the original shape and shape of the material cycle between deformed and original shape with on cooling and heating. Let me inform you that this is plastic deformation and strain energy is stored in the material and released on heating by recovering the original shape. In the superelasticity, materials are stressed in the elasticity limit. In the parenthesis region and uniform releasing, material recover the original shape by exhibiting elastic material behavior. Thermal induced martensitic transformation is lattice distorting fast transformation and occurs in the material in thermal manner on cooling along with the lattice twinning and ordered parenthesis structures turn into the twinned martensitic structures. Twinned martensitic structures turn into the detwinned martensitic or reoriented martensitic structures by means of stress-induced martensitic transformation applying the external stress. This is the schematic or Schepp-Mohler cycle in the crystallographic level. Let me inform you that Schepp-Mohler effect and superelasticity is observed in the beta phase region of the material and ordered phase structure is essential. In the Schepp-Mohler effect, first step is cooling, and on cooling, ordered parenthesis structures of material turn into the detwinned martensitic structures by means of thermal induced martensitic transformation. Second step is the deformation, and with this deformation, twinned martensitic structures turn into the detwinned martensitic structures by means of stress induced martensitic transformation. And after that, on cooling, the detwinned structures turn into the ordered parenthesis structures by means of reverse austenitic transformation. And structure of material cycle between the detwinned and ordered parenthesis structures on cooling and heating. This is also schematic of superelasticity. In the superelasticity, materials are stressed in the parenthesis region. And with this stress, ordered parenthesis structure turn into the detwinned martensitic structures by means of stress-induced martensitic transformation. And upon releasing, detwinned structures of material turn into the ordered parenthesis structures by means of reverse austenitic transformation. Superelasticity is also linked with stress-induced martensitic transformation, which is induced by applying only mechanical stress. With this stress, parent austenitic phase structure turn into the detwinned martensitic structures, as in the deformation step of Schepp-Mohler effect, then detwinned martensitic structure turn into the parent phase structure upon releasing. It is important that crystal structures cycle between parent phase structures and detwinned martensitic structures on stressing and releasing. Also, it is important that stress-strain curve exhibit nonlinear behavior and stressing and releasing paths are different and hysteresis loops refers to the energy dissipation. This is the stressing and releasing path in the superelasticity. As you can see, stressing and releasing paths are different and hysteresis loops refers to the energy dissipation. Copper-based alloys exhibit this property in the metastable beta phase region of the material. Lattice invariances and lattice twinning are not uniform in these alloys and cause the formation of layered structures. One monotype planes of the parent phase turn into the unusual layer structure which consists of an array of fluorescent pocket planes with complicated stacking sequences as 3R, 9R, or 18R martensites depending on the stacking sequences on the fluorescent pocket planes of the ordered lattice. The periodicity and therefore the unit cell is contained through 18 layers in direction Z in case of 18 R martensitic structures. These are the basic terms and definitions related to the Shape-Mummery effect and superelasticity. As you can see, Shape-Mummery effect and as you can see, experimental studies were performed to couple the Shape-Mummery alloys. These are copper zinc aluminum and copper aluminum mangan alloys. You can see alloy composition and decomposition were selected in the beta phase region of the alloys. As you can see, martensit start and martensit finish temperatures are over the room temperatures, and both of the alloy samples are completely in the product martensit state at the room temperatures. Specimens obtained from these alloys were solution treated for homogenation in the beta phase field as following, then quenched in ice brain. These temperatures are 830 and 700 degrees for copper zinc aluminum and copper aluminum mangan alloys. And these temperatures were selected in the beta phase region of the material. Harder specimens for X-ray examination were prepared by filling the alloys, and these specimens were sealed in evacuated quartz tubes and given beta phase homogenization treatments to release the strain effect and other imperfection. These temperatures are also were selected at the same temperatures, 830 and 700 degrees, and homogenization time were selected 15 minutes. Powder diffractorums were obtained for all the specimens at the different stage of aging in a long time interval. This is an X-ray diffractorum taken from copper zinc aluminum alloy samples after long-term aging at room temperature for about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, peak intensities and peak intensities are different, and this profile exhibit superlattice reflection. Let me inform you that these plane pairs are important in the ternary copper bay shape model alloys. These are 1-2, 2-0-2, 1-8, 2-0-8, 1-10, 2-0-10, and others. This is another X-ray diffractorum taken from copper aluminum mangan alloy samples after long-term aging at room temperature for about 50 years after quenching. As you can see, this diffractorum also exhibits the same characters with this plane pairs. A series of X-ray diffractorums have been taken from both of the alloy samples in a long time interval, and some change have been observed in the diffraction angles, peak intensities, and peak characteristics with age and duration. In particular, some of the successive peak pairs have shifted toward each other, and these peak pairs provide the following relation. These plane pairs can be listed as follows, as I mentioned at the diffractorum, 1-2, 2-0-2, 1-8, 2-0-8, 1-10, 2-0-10, 0-3, 0-4, 0-3, 2-0, and others. At the long-term investigation, it is observed that these peak pairs come close to each other with aging, and this change refers to the changes in the crystal structure of material.
Hi, Dr. Osman. Your time is almost up.
Yeah, 1 minute.
Sure.
Second experimental study were performed on the electron microscope. As you can see, electron diffraction patterns also superlattice reflections. In conclusion, Shape-Mummery effect is evaluated by the structural change in microscopic scale by means of martensitic transformation. The fundamental structure of the beta-type martensites are orthorhombic closed pocket structures, which consist of an array of closed pocket planes in coupled-based Shape-Mummery alloys. Let these invariantials and let these twinnings are uniform in the solvers and give rise to the formation unusual complex layer stretches, and they are characterized by the sticking sequences on the depending on the order in the parenthesis. Couples by ternary always have the deuterated superlattice in parenthesis and following sticking sequences occur with the Martin stick transformation. The sequences are A, B, C, B, C, A, C, A, B, A, B, C, B, C, A, C, and A, B for 18 are Martin stick structures. Based on the austenite Martin stick relation, the Wazer plane of 9R or 18R Martin sites originated from the 1-1 type planes of current phase on which lattice invariantials occur into opposite direction with the Martin stick transformation. These are the references. And thank you very much for your attention. If anybody has question, I will try to answer.
Okay, thanks, Dr. Osman.